Gearhart's back.
The more things change, the more they stay the same.
From NJ1015.com, this is the new Jim Gearhart Podcast.
I had something I wanted to do. I haven't gotten on the soapbox for a while. Sort of gave up. I had a piece. Dennis Malloy did a piece on the website, NJ1015.com, that rang a bell. And Dennis was talking about the new governor, whom I've never met, do not know him. But Dennis, the essence of Dennis's piece was, here is a governor who just doesn't get it. And he came to the conclusion that, of course, he's met the governor. He's a nice, affable, pleasant man. And so he's not incarnate evil, but he just doesn't get what's going on. I'd watch out for the incarnate evil thing, because the fact to say that a politician is a very pleasant person is like saying, hey, that carpenter has a hammer. It's the tool of the trade. He was talking about a reality gap between the progressive elite's pie in the sky and the practical reality of middle-class New Jersey's pork roll in the refrigerator. So, and there's quite a bit of difference. To throw around tax hikes, other policies that further squeeze the average Jersey family with no idea of what the squeeze feels like, because you've never been in that situation, certainly not within memory. And it hurts not only financially, but physically, mentally, constant anxiety of trying to make ends meet in a very, very expensive state where the price of everything goes up and the income is sort of dead in the water for most of us. And you have to put food on the table, and it's a very difficult thing to do. Somebody eats it up, more out of your income with taxes. But this does not seem to occur to anybody. Now, what really got my attention was that Dennis had mentioned the progressive elite, that's my term, not his, but living in a bubble. And that rang a bell, because it is completely apt. It's a perfect metaphor for how these people live. The political progressive elite believe their view is the only view, because in the bubble, in their whole circle or environment, nobody ever disagrees with it. Mm. And I got a couple of examples here that I recall. There was a lady in a very wealthy society, matron in New York, well-connected, well-known, who once had mentioned, I think it was the George Bush presidency, the second George Bush. And she says, I don't know how he got elected. There's something not right here. And she had suspected that there was some kind of political chicanery going on there. And she says, I've talked to all of my friends. I don't have any friends. Haven't heard of anybody who actually voted for him. And that was one. The second is non-political, but I love the story. Old John D. Rockefeller, who was, you know, the richest man, I guess, in the this end of the galaxy, once had told his advertising people or his people, no advertising on Sunday. Well, that wasn't because of a blue law or for religious purposes. He said, well, on Sunday, everybody's at the polo matches. Nobody's going to hear. And so this is what living in the bubble is like. Dennis's bubble is the perfect metaphor for this insulation from reality and this bubble think that they have. But I think Dennis, although he hit that nail right on the head, I don't think he went to the next question, which is, okay, so why do we put up with it? Why do we keep reelecting people who are totally out of touch with us? In effect, we're voluntarily chaining ourselves to an unthinking, sort of uncaring machine that keeps grinding us into frustrated, anxiety-ridden pulp. And we are ignored by the very institutions we depend on for our lives and that of our families. It's kind of like, We go out every election, we lie down in front of a political steamroller. And it doesn't see us. It only is programmed with its own course, which is rule of the elite.
For more great content from the New Jersey 101.5 news, weather, traffic, and talk teams, click our logo to subscribe to our channel, comment below, and feel free to share with all your friends and family.